The second half of the It story is finally here. Man, this was not worth the wait in the slightest. I really enjoyed the first It movie. I thought although it relied too heavily on jump scares and some of the special effects weren't that great, the film was incredibly entertaining, had a great script, a bunch of fantastic performances, and some really creepy moments. In terms of blockbuster horror movies in the 2010s, the first movie stands alongside The Conjuring as one of the best in my opinion. But Chapter 2 falls way too heavily into many of the tropes of bad sequels. Some of the things I liked in the first film do come back, the performances are great, and there are a couple set pieces I really liked. But the film also seems to copy all of the previous movie's flaws and massively inflate them. Although the first film leaned heavily on jump scares, many of them I thought were either really well done or pretty unexpected, with a few huge exceptions. But in this film, there was not a single jump scare that I found was necessary or even unexpected. In fact, the way they set them up was so lazy that it completely took me out of the film. I am very easy to make jump. When watching a film, 99% of the time I would jump at every single jump scare, and sometimes even at just loud noises that weren't meant to make you jump. In this film, I think after like 3,000 jump scares, only a couple actually got me. Of course, that is hyperbole, there aren't actually 3,000, but it definitely feels like that. And that's because the timing of them is so obvious that you can basically plot down the exact second something is going to jump out. This is made even worse by the score, which every single time builds up right before the scare. Pretty much every single jump scare in the movie as well is a fake out scare followed by the real scare. The crescendo of the music happens and then nothing happens until 2 seconds later when the actual thing jumps out. It comes off so lazily and stupidly that it completely ruins all the scenes of horror. Another problem I have with these scenes is that a lot of them were pretty unintentionally hilarious. The scene with the old woman made the entire cinema screening I was at burst out laughing because it was so ridiculous. It completely ruined genuinely creepy bits like Pennywise putting his makeup on that was straight after it. The only really great set piece in the film for me was the funhouse scene, which I thought was really exciting and creepy. In the original story, the two timelines alternated throughout, but as they took all the scenes of the Losers Club as kids out for the first movie, they decided to improvise by adding in brand new scenes of the Losers Club as kids here. These flashbacks point out one of the biggest flaws of this movie, as well as the story in general, and that is that the characters are so boring as adults, but so entertaining to watch as children. In this movie, I honestly couldn't remember much about any character, whereas in the previous movie I could remember everything about them. And when you're watching an almost 3-hour movie, the characters have to be fun to watch, otherwise the film is just gonna be a chore to sit through. Yeah, speaking of its length, it is way too long. The film doesn't justify its length whatsoever, and it's just so boring. Compared to other 3-hour movies from this year, like Endgame or Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, this film doesn't hold a candle. Those films were engrossing and incredibly entertaining. This film really dragged and was pretty far from entertaining for the most part. Although there is still a lot of heart in the story and the ending is pretty charming, the film feels never ending. The performances don't help with this, not to say that anyone is really bad, but the actors completely lack any chemistry that they had in the original movie. It feels like they all just met on set 5 seconds before filming every scene. Bill Hader probably gives the best performance from the Losers Club, however I think the writing for his character wasn't the best and it kind of ruined him at times, especially when you have these really horrific scenes that are kind of ruined by these awkward lines that he says. It makes sense for him to try and break the tension with humor, but it's not something to really translate into the screen very well. Of course, once again, Bill Skarsgård is the show stealer in the movie. His performance is just fantastic. There are a few more issues I have with the film, but they would go more into the spoiler territory, which I don't want to really get into, so I'll end my list of flaws by bringing up the CGI in the movie. The CGI in the first movie wasn't amazing, but it was never really bad. However, in this film, it is absolutely atrocious. For an almost $80 million film, the effects look cheap and rushed. The de-aging of the younger Losers Club looked pretty damn good and is a great example of very subtle effects working better than huge spots. spectacles. But all the creature effects look so fake and ridiculous that it took me out of many of these scenes, especially in the old woman scene I brought up earlier, the restaurant scene, and the final battle of the movie. Overall, It Chapter 2 is a bit of a colossal, overblown mess. I didn't hate it, and there are parts I liked, but it doesn't hold a candle to the previous movie, and despite its ridiculous length, it's a pretty forgettable movie overall. I'm going to give it a 4.5 out of 10.